Leilani Alman. Okay.
Was that the last one?
That is the last one.
Whoever you are, we love you.
Okay. And it had to be somebody, so.
Cool. Oh, Nita, oh, do I go? Is that like on? Is like,
yeah.
Oh, okay. So anyhow, I grew up in Temecula, and right now I live in Marietta, but yeah, I went to Temecula Valley High School and all that, and I have to say, one thing I learned about Temecula is that it's pretty boring. So that would explain why your Muslim community is actually pretty boring. I've met these people, and like, well, I haven't really met them. I mean, I've checked out their mosque and stuff, you know, I went to their Jummah and I did all that stuff. And I keep wondering, why do these people make news? Like, seriously, I was at Juma on Friday, and you know what they were talking about? They were talking about WikiLeaks. They're not even talking about wife beating or, like, Hamas or terrorism. They were talking about WikiLeaks. And you know what their speech was? It was, like, something like, okay, everybody, there's going to be an even bigger WikiLeaks here. It's coming up, and it's called the Day of Judgment. So you better watch yourselves because Allah, you know, He records everything that you do. So there's going to be an even bigger WikiLeaks. I mean, really, this is what they talk about. It's not like terrorism or anything. These people are, like, totally boring. Like, well, no, that actually was a really cool one. That was, like, their best sermon I've heard yet. But, like, I'm just saying, like, why do they make news? I don't get it. Like, anyhow,
You've been drinking coffee?
Okay. Anyhow.
Whatever she's been drinking, I want some, okay?
No, I just get nervous, you know? Like, I'm just saying, I don't get it. Like, I've seen crazy Muslim people before. Why don't we focus on crazy people? They're not even crazy. But, like, okay. Also, people are freaked out about Fajr, I notice. And that's, like, the thing I love to crash. It's the morning prayer. And they do that, like, really super early in the morning. They do it, like, 6 a.m. or whatever. And I don't get it. Why are people saying there's, like, a big traffic issue? Because I swear, I love going to Fajr because, like, the roads are, like, totally clear. I go from Marriott Hot Springs Road down Margarita Road, like, past Chaparral, and there's, like, no one there. So I'm like, well, what's the big traffic issue? Like, seriously, there's, like, no one in the area. So, like, why are people freaked out that that, like, one prayer is gonna, like, create this huge, giant traffic issue? Yeah. Anyhow, I was also gonna bring up, like, the call to prayer thing. Like, I know they've been over it and everything, but, yeah, I was just gonna say, like, well, I mean, I don't think it makes sense, because I was listening to this comedian. His name is Ahmed Ahmed. He's, like, Egyptian or something. He's, like, Egyptian-American, and, yeah, I talk really fast, I know, but anyhow, Ahmed Ahmed was saying that, like, he was talking about, like, Bahrain or something. Like, if you're Muslim and you walk through, like, some Muslim countries, like, all of a sudden, like, you'll hear the adhan, like, the call to prayer for Isha, and, like, it's, like, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, and then all of a sudden, it's, like, boom, 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 and you look over, and it's, like, a nightclub, and it's drowning out the call to prayer. And, like, if you're Muslim, you have to, like, decide, do I go clubbing or do I go pray? And, see, and, like, what I'm saying is, it's, like, the reason to blast the call to prayer is because they're assuming Muslim people are, like, walking around and they have to, like, decide. They don't really need to do that because there's not, like, Muslim people walking around all over the place. It's not, like, 99% Muslim. Like, they know what time it is to pray. Like, you can go on a website and look up the time to pray, and then you can, like, just, like, set an alarm clock, and then you'll know, like, okay, I have to go to the mosque now. Like, they don't have to, like, blast it or anything. So that kind of, like, makes sense. You know, like, we have modern technology. Like, I was gonna, like, talk to you about, like, this story I was reading once about, like, the night prayer. Like, the, like, not Isha, but the one that comes after that. It's, like, optional. And it comes before Fajr. And it was, like, in the 7th century. And there's, like, these two Muslim guys. And this one Muslim guy's like, okay, I really want to pray Salatul Layl. And so his friend was like, okay, I'll just watch the sky and, like, I'll wake you up when it's time. And he's like, oh, okay, so he goes to sleep, and, you know, his friend is like, okay, just keep sleeping, and then he's like, waking up, oh, is it time to pray yet? And he starts, no, no, I'm still watching the sky, and, like, he goes back to sleep again. Like, is it time? And his friend's like, no, it's not time yet. I'm looking at the sky, it's not time. Okay, go back to sleep, and then all of a sudden, you know, friend's looking at the sky, and he's like, okay, it's almost Fajr, wake up now. This is the best time to pray Salatul Layl. He's like, okay, we're gonna pray now. But see, we have modern technology now, so we don't need some guy to, like, blast it down for everyone to know and to, like, stare at the sky all night. Like, we have the internet, and we have, like, alarm clocks and things like that, so you don't have to, like, blast the call to prayer. Like, we have modern technology, and the thing is, you can't blast things in the 7th century. You can't have megaphones or things like that blasting the call to prayer because it didn't exist back then. So there's nothing in, like, the tradition of Islam that says that you have to have, like, megaphones and microphones. phones and whatnot, doing that. So, yeah, I know.
You make me look calm.
Yeah, I know. It's because, like, I'm not a good, like, speaker. I get really nervous. I hope people understood this on, like, some level. But, yeah, I think that was pretty much it. There's no one at Fajr. Like, I don't think that's going to be a big deal. Like, seriously. Also, you're working on the assumption that Muslims, like, always pray, and they, like, never do, seriously. They don't pray all five prayers. Like, there's, like, five guys at Fajr. Like, I showed up there, and they're, like, all old. Like, seriously. They're not going to make, like, a huge deal. They have, like, chairs because they have, like, arthritis. Like,
well, Lonnie, I could listen to you all night, but unfortunately, your time is up, and
okay,
thank you very much. Okay, we have no other speakers, is that?
That's correct.
Okay, in that case, I will close the public hearing. Finally.